In this video, we are going to code an expert advisor for this triple exponential moving average. So let's find out how to do that with MQL5. To get started, please click on a little button here or press F4 on your keyboard. Now you should see the Metaeditor window, and here you want to click on File, New File, Expert Advisor from Template, Continue. I will call this file Simple Triple EMA, click on Continue, Continue and Finish. Now you can delete everything above the ontick function and the two command lines here. We start with an include statement to include the file trade.mqh. This one comes with MQL5. And now we use the class ctrade and create an instance called trade that we are going to use later on to open positions. We want to calculate the ask price for buy positions. That is done by using symbol info double. For the current symbol on the chart, we use symbol underscore ask, and with normalized double and underscore digits, we automatically calculate the right number of digits behind the dot. Let's repeat that for the bid price. Everything is identical except for the variable name, and this time we are going to use symbol underscore bid as the second parameter. Afterwards, we use the function mqlrates to create an array called priceInfo. And with array set as series, we are going to sort the array downwards from the current candle. And finally, we can use copyRates to fill the array. For the current symbol on the chart and the currently selected period on the chart, we start with candle 0, that's the current candle, and copy the price data for 3 candles to store it inside of our price info array. Let's create a string variable called signal for our signal, but we are not going to assign any value here because this is what we want to calculate now. Therefore, we create 3 arrays for each of the exponential moving average values. This one is for 10 candles, the second one is for 50 candles, and the third one is for 100 candles. The integrated IMA function that comes with MQL5 can be used to create an exponential moving average. For the current symbol on the chart, we use underscore period to calculate it for the current period. In this example, I've done it for 10 candles. We don't use a shift value here, and we want to create an exponential moving average. Therefore, we use mode underscore EMA, and the result should be calculated based on the close price. Now let's repeat the whole thing for the other two exponential moving averages. Everything is identical except for the name of the variable and the number of candles. This is the last one for 100 candles. Those arrays also need to be sorted from the current candle downwards. So let's repeat that for all the 3 arrays. And as you might have guessed, we use copy buffer to fill each array with data according to the definition that we have created. We do that for buffer 0, that's the signal line, starting from candle 0. And in this case, we do it for 10 candles. Please make sure that you use different names for the EMA and for the EMA arrays here. And now we can calculate if we have a buy signal. And that would be the case if the exponential moving average for 10 candles is bigger than the one for 50 candles. And if the exponential moving average array for 50 candles is bigger than the one for 100 candles. If that is the case, we have a buy signal, and that's when we want to assign the word buy to our signal. In the other case, if we have a moving average for 10 candles that is below the one for 50 candles, and if the one for 50 candles is also below the one for 100 candles, that's when we want to sell. So now we assign the word sell to our signal. And if our signal equals sell and the return value for positions total is below 1, that would mean we have no open positions but a sell signal. And that's when we use trade.sell to sell 10 micro lot. In the other case, if the signal equals buy and we also have no open positions, that's when we use trade.buy and buy 10 micro lot. Finally, we use the command statement to create an output on our chart. We want to see the current signal is followed by the calculated signal. Okay, that's about it. If this was too fast for you, or if you have no idea what all the code here does, maybe you want to watch one of the other videos in this basic video series, or maybe even the premium course on our website might be interesting for you. For now, please click on the compile button or press F7. You shouldn't get any errors, and if this is the case, you can click on the little button here or press F4 to go back to MetaTrader. And in MetaTrader, we click on View, Strategy Tester, or press Ctrl and R. Please pick the new file simple-triple-ema.ex5, mark the option for the visual mode here, and start a test. Here we are. The expert advisor is running. This is our first position. And we see a sell signal on the chart. Now we have a crossover, and in a few seconds we should get a buy signal. That happened now, so our expert advisor is working as expected. And in this little video, you have learned how to create an expert advisor for a triple exponential moving average. And you have coded it yourself with a few lines of MQL5 code.